we discuss the concepts of loops in Java. Previous class we discussed operators, all operators are over. Now control structures, we'll discuss control structures. Control structures now. First control structure is if loop, if else, and while loops. First is if else. How we declare if else in Java? Now we see the declaration of if else. Here statement, here again if, it is if loop, and another one, another model, if else, here if, same boolean expression, here we say statement. And next here else, if condition is true, execute this one. If condition is false, execute this one. These two are same. If it is false, then next statement is executed. Next, if else is over, next we do iteration. Iteration mode. Iteration is, for iteration we can take while loop. We take while loop, while and do while loops. Example of the form of while loop is while boolean expression here true or false type. Like example of boolean expression is x greater than or equal to y, like this. The example of expression. Here statement, it is iteration statement. Here greater than or equal to 5 is nothing but if the value is 7 or 8 or nothing, this statement is executed. Now we see the examples of while loop. Public class while test. While test. Public class while test. Here public static void main, simple form. Argument. Here we declare the variables. Equal to 0. And here we while loop. While all is less than 0.99d. Okay, now we take iteration or equal to math. Here math function random. System dot out dot print error. Here we take while loop. Here class declaration while test. Main function double we take a variable or double variable declaration. Here we take while loop. If the variable here first is 0, the variable is less than 0.99, then the statement is executed. The variable we take r equal to 0.5 or thing, this one is executed. and below 0.9, this one executed sequentially, iteratively. Next we take do by. The form of do by is do yes statement your while. Here the test statement, boolean statement. Here the test statement. The do while statement is of this form. Do and conditions. Here the statements, and here the condition is there. While condition. First the statement is executed, and then afterwards the condition is tested. The condition is okay. Then again go to the previous loop. Difference between this and this is, it will execute at least once. It is execute after condition only. Difference between these two, do while and while. Here we take example of do while. Here we take example public class. List characters here public static void main string arguments. Here for loop, here take for loop character. Here declare the character variable for loop c equal to 0. C less than 128 C++. C loop for loop for the character c 0 to 128 variables. Here if condition, if c not equal to 26, c is not equal to 26, this one is executed. Variable and casting int, casting variable int variable string and casting string and characters. Display the all characters from 0 to 128. Expect 26. Here this is if loop. Okay. Next one is the comma operator. We use the comma operator. Where we use comma? In for loops you can use comma operators. Next is comma operator. Comma operator here. Take example of comma. Public class. Comma operator. In a public static void main. Here we take for loops. String argument. Here we take for loop. For int. I equal to 1, j equal to i++. plus 10. I less than 5. We have semicolon. I plus plus. Here we use comma. J equal to I into 2. Here we use comma operator in the for loop. Here also comma. Two commas are we used in the for loop. And next, system.out.println. Here we print the I. Printing statement declaration is like this. Here printing declaration. I, J. I variable is taken here, j variable taken here. Here the comma operator. You can use in the for loop comma operator. Next we discuss break and continue. So here the what are the topics are over. First the control structures. Here the control structures first is if else statement. If the condition is true, this statement is executed. Okay, it is one form. Another form is if the condition is true, this is executed. Next, otherwise this statement executed. Here else, if and else, two forms are there. And next one is while loop. Here we take example of while, public class while, while and do while. Public static void means arguments. First we take variable double. Here we take the while function. Okay, this is a while declaration, while while expression statement. Here while this is expression, this statement is executed here, and then print statement. This is one form. While statement executed, then another one executed, like repeatedly iteration form. Next do while. Here in the do statement first executed, and then while iteration like this one. Difference between these two is here the statement compulsory executed at least one time. Here after condition true only, then statement is executed. Okay. Next one is here we take some while loop like example. Public class list characters list. We can display the characters from 1 to 128. 0 to for loop, we can take for loop 0 to 128 C declaration, character declaration. If the C is not equal to 26, we print the values. Here casting character casted here, character casted to int. Here display characters and integers. In this one system.out.println, integers and characters are printed here from 1 to 128. These are over. Next comma operator. Here the comma operator is there. Comma operator we can frequently use in the for loop. Here we take comma operator class name. Here the public static void main, and here we take a for loop. Int variable first declaration. Two declarations are there, I and j. I equal 1, j equal I plus 10. Comma in between there. Second declaration condition, I less than or equal to 5, less than 5. Here the increment statement, I plus plus, and then next statement j equal to I plus 2. In between those statements, you can declare the comma. Okay. In the iterations we can use comma operator. Here we print the output. Okay, like this. Three statements are over, iteration statements, control structures, if else, do while, comma and not iteration, for loop is there. Okay, next topic is there. Now we take a break and continue statement. Break and continue. Break quits the loop. Loop is there. Break will be quits the loop without executing the rest of statements. That is the break meaning. Continue is nothing but stop the execution of the current statement. Go back to the beginning of the loop or next iteration. We take the example of break and continue.